Children's Mercy has earned a national reputation as one of the best children's hospitals in the country. In fact, this year we were nationally ranked by U.S. News and World Report as one of only 23 children's hospitals in the nation to rank in all 10 pediatric specialties. You know, awards and recognitions are meaningful, but to me, this is about our people and the trust that they build with our patients and our families. It's our people that make that happen. Now, I have the opportunity to sit down with Dr. Steve Olsen, our division director for neonatology, to hear about his team and what they have accomplished to help us earn our ranking, the challenges he's seen and are working to overcome, and the future of neonatology. Steve, first of all, thank you for joining us. And first of all, I want to say congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Our neonatology program jumped to being ranked number 14 in the country in the last U.S. News and World Report rankings. And maybe we can start the conversation by you talking a little bit about the team that you have that assembles and comes together and has been able to deliver these kinds of results that were reflected in the rankings.
Yeah, we have a great team. Our team is comprised of physicians, nurse practitioners, bedside nurses, nutritionists, social workers, therapists, all kinds of other ancillary support services. No one discipline can do things by themselves. It's a complete team effort. I think we tend to really focus on CLABSIs, you know, our central line associated bloodstream infections. All hospitals do. And I think we have really been able to make some inroads and see a lot of success in that. And that's just one example of the fact that it takes everybody to have those good quality outcomes. It takes everybody, and it also takes every day. You know, you can't just take a day off here or there because it's that constant vigilance. And that's really one of the things that we've seen a lot of success with.
Yeah, that's fantastic. And I know one of the big issues and priorities for us as an organization and for the country is to address disparities and lack of equity in healthcare, especially as it relates to the young babies that we support and the moms as well. Tell us a little bit about how we are addressing some of those inequities and disparities.
Yeah, we take care of a very diverse population, 5 to 6 state region, families, babies from all walks of life. And so I think one of the biggest things that we've recently done is really start to acknowledge that and make awareness of that. So, you know, our flagship is our level 4 NICU here at Children's Mercy, 83-bed NICU. But in our division, we take care of 160 to 165 patients a day through 10 other NICUs. And really, I look at that as a possibility to bring academic neonatology to our community hospitals where moms have delivered. We're able to keep those babies close to them, but still provide the care that we can here at Children's Mercy. Now, we unfortunately have babies that need to come to Children's, and we do that. So there's no question about that, but that affiliated partnership has been really beneficial for us.
Steve, one of the things that's so important for us as an organization and our culture is storytelling. What stories come to mind over the past year or two that is really reflected in our people bringing our mission to life every day?
Well, one story that comes to mind is we had a baby from rural Kansas that got acutely ill and had to be transported here to Children's. So our transport team did a great job getting the baby here. The baby was very unstable for the first couple of days of life and actually was diagnosed with COVID. Unfortunately, the baby continued to get more and more ill and actually ended up on ECMO. So this was one of the first babies with COVID that was treated with ECMO that we could find in the country. The ECMO course was difficult, was long, but the baby was able to come off, remained with us in our NICU for quite some time and had some pretty significant lung disease. But in a way, that gave us in the NICU a little glimpse of the issues that COVID could cause and how dramatic it can be.
Wow, that's incredible. You know, we're so proud of the accomplishments that we've made over the past year to 2 years, but we also think 5 to 10 years out, in terms of the opportunities and challenges that we may have to address. What are your thoughts on the outlook for neonatology over the next 5 to 10 years?
Well, everything in neonatology is based on outcomes. And all of our big multi-center research studies have a neurodevelopmental assessment around 2 years of age to see how these babies are doing. We've participated in many of those studies over the last 10 years, and we'll continue to participate in those follow-up efforts. Genomics is always going to be a forefront, and making diagnoses earlier. We see some very complex babies in the fetal health center, and so learning about them from a genomics standpoint, even before they're born, is going to help us in the future as well.
Yeah, that's so exciting. This is why we do what we do. Dr. Steve Olsen, thank you so much for joining us today. I'm thankful for your leadership. We're so thankful for the work of your great team that you are a part of and help to lead. So thank you all for joining us today, and we'll see you soon.